मटर अमेरिका। आई अंडरस्टैंड रिपर्टरी एज ए मटर अमेरिका, बट इन डिफरेंट आउटलाइन, इन डिफरेंट कंस्ट्रक्शन, इन डिफरेंट फॉर्मेट। देर इज नो सेपरेट एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ द रिपर्टरी इन द अब्सेंस ऑफ द मटर अमेरिका। सो इट इज ए मटर अमेरिका, हाउएवर मेड वेरी सिंपलिस्टिक, वेरी यूजफुल, वेरी प्रैक्टिकल, विद द इनॉर्मस अनालिसिस, द इंजीनियरिंग पार्ट ऑफ द बनोहसन केंट एंड मेनी अदर फेलो टीचर्स। आई थिंक विदाउट रिपर्टरी द होम्योपैथी विल बी मच मोर इन डिफिकल्टी। देर इज ए लेटर रिटर्न बाय डॉक्टर हनीमान टू स्टाफ, वन ऑफ हिज डिसाइपल्स। हनीमान हैड टू न्यू केसेस दिस मंथ। सो हनीमान हैज रिटर्न टू स्टाफ, आई हैव टू केसेस एंड आई हैव नो टाइम नाउ टू फाइंड अ रेमेडी, एंड डोंट राइट मी एनी लेटर फॉर एटलीस्ट 2 मंथ्स, आई एम वेरी बिजी नाउ। दिस एग्जैक्टली गिव्स अस हाउ हनीमान विदाउट द रिपल्टरी वॉज सर्चिंग फॉर ए रेमेडी अमंग्स द मटर अमेरिका पेजेस। एंड यू कैन सी नाउ द होम्योपैथ्स एंजॉइंग मोर देन 4,000 रेमेडीज ऑफ द मटर अमेरिका विथ दिस सॉफ्टवेयर एंड दैट सॉफ्टवेयर, वेल द वर्क ऑफ ए होम्योपैथ इज मच मच इजी। एंड आई एम वेरी हैप्पी दैट द सॉफ्टवेयर कंपनीज इन होम्योपैथी कीप पेस विथ द डेवलपमेंट्स एंड विथ द रैपिड टेम्पो, विच इज ए बिग बिग कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन। एंड आई मस्ट मेन्शन दैट देर आर इंडियन कंपनीज, देर आर फॉरेन कंपनीज विच आर डिवोटेड टू द यूज ऑफ द सॉफ्टवेयर, एंड एवरी सॉफ्टवेयर हैज इट्स ओन बेनिफिट्स टू ऑफर टू ए प्रैक्टिसिंग होम्योपैथ। सो वी हैव गॉन टू डीप इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग मेनी कॉन्सेप्ट्स, एंड आई ऑलवेज से दैट अनेकांतवादा इज ए जैनिक डॉक्ट्रीन, जैनिज्म डॉक्ट्रीन ऑफ मेनीनेस ऑफ ट्रूथ। आई रोट एन आर्टिकल ओवर अनेकांतवादा एंड होम्योपैथी, विच इज ए पार्ट ऑफ माई प्रेजेंटेशन इन हार्मोनियन बुक, वेयर द कॉन्सेप्ट इज देर आर मेनी वेज टू गो फॉर द डेस्टिनेशन ऑफ द ट्रूथ, एंड ऑल दीज वेज टू अचीव दी डेस्टिनेशन हैव देयर ओन राइट प्लेस इन द डायरेक्शन इन द जर्नी। एंड आई थिंक दिस इज एग्जैक्टली वॉट द स्टडी ऑफ द मटर अमेरिका, द स्टडी ऑफ द रिपल्टरी गिव्स टू ए होम्योपैथ, दैट द अप्रोच टू द डेस्टिनेशन ऑफ द रेमिडी इज थ्रू सिम्टमैटोलॉजी, इज थ्रू अनालिसिस, इज थ्रू अंडरस्टैंडिंग, एंड रिपल्टरी प्लेज अ वेरी वाइटल रोल इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग द रेमिडी। सो द डेस्टिनेशन इज वेरी इजी, the pathway is very clear, and each repertory Dr. Ronak will explain to you, each repertory has its own philosophical background which is very very important to understand. So this question which has been put to me by John is a very pertinent question. Without repertory we will be handicapped, we will be mutilated, and we will be going on searching like Hanuman, one case for so many pages that we cannot practice. So our travel has been at par with the speed which is demanded of by the modern tempo of life, and we have to salute therefore every software company, every researcher and investigator who has made the human science of homeopathy very easy. Yeah.
Wow. Thank you, Dr. Ajit Kulkarni, sir, for your kind words and a very wonderful insight into the need of the hour. I think it is mandatory.
Yeah.
Every homeopath, whether he is a BHMS, MD, a practitioner, non, should master the repertory. So that is an excellent tool. As a surgeon, without a scalpel or without a knife, he cannot operate. I think a homeopath cannot attend to any patient without a repertory by his bedside or in the OPDs. Dr. Frederick Schrein, so many doctors have written. I was trying practice, but life and practice has improved and changed tremendously after I started using repertory. So it is a humble attempt from all of us, Dr. Ronaksha, Dr. Ajit Kulkarni, sir, and myself, that every homeopath, we want to be successful. We want to be the best. But I believe if you don't use the best tools, and if you don't use the experience of the best homeopathic doctors with you, you cannot be the best. Am I right, sir?
Yeah.
So that is possible. We have been gifted as a wonderful science by Dr. Hanuman. He expects each one of us to be master prescribers, not just average. To be a master prescriber, the journey starts with a proper understanding of organon, of medicine, a deep insight of the repertory, excellent knowledge of the clinical side of the patient. I put it as CD-ROM. Clinical diagnosis, excellent knowledge of R, that is repertory, organon, and materia medica. The short form is clinical diagnosis, repertory. A combination of all these four will only just make you the best homeopathic physician to handle every case which you have either in your clinic, in the hospital, or in the intensive. So with these words, I would like to start today's presentation by the dynamic speaker today, Dr. Ronaksha. I was introduced to him last year when we started our free online webinars during the initial lockdown, and I'm grateful to God that he introduced to me to the dynamic speakers, especially Dr. Ajit Kulkarni, sir, Dr. Ronaksha, and have come together to give the best to the homeopaths of India and world. So Dr. Ronaksha is an excellent teacher and head of department of repertory at Baroda Homeopathy Medical College. He is a very dedicated person. I think more than 2/3 of his life, that's what I was talking to him yesterday, he has been only living and thinking about homeopathy and repertory. I think there is no better person in India today who can speak about repertory. And over to you, Dr. Ronaksha, for your presentation. Request the participants to kindly be muted. If you have any questions, we will answer each of your questions, anything related to repertory, understanding repertory. We are starting the module one of repertory tomorrow, the first session at 3:30 to 5:30. There are a lot of inquiries coming. Why it is 3:30? As Dr. Ronaksha is teaching and he's so dedicated to 3:30, he doesn't want to waste time. On dot at 3:30, he would start the presentation of the modules. So we have such a wonderful teacher here with us. And I think we should not miss this opportunity. This lockdown, I think one good thing is happening. It has given each of us homeopaths a lot of time to rethink, to grow, to learn, so that we can become better homeopaths. Over to you, Dr. Ramesh.
Thank you, Dr. John, for inviting me, first of all. And also, I am very much thankful of Dr. Ajit Kulkarni, sir, for inspiring, and we have heard about him. We read his books also, and he is very much attached with the Baroda memories, as he has already told about Tarkeshwar. So once again, I'm thankful of Dr. John as well as Dr. Ajit Kulkarni, sir. Now, today is a demo about our module course of homeopathic repertory. We all are knowing that the repertory is a very important tool for conscientious homeopathic practice. It's really very well said by Dr. Pierre Smith that no homeopath in the world can practice conscientiously without the help of repertory. Just I'm giving the example. In Hahnemann time, there was 200 remedies in his practice, right? In the synthesis repertory, if you see, there are more than 4,000 remedies are there. So is it possible to remember each remedy symptoms by human mind? Just ask question to yourself. How it is possible to remember? If you cannot remember your old friends and school names and so many other old memories, how you can remember the name of the remedies with symptomatology in detail? And that was very strongly felt by Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, and that is why he himself made a repertory and used in his practice. So many students, so many doctors are arguing with us, and that Dr. Ajit Kulkarni has also told that it is one of the most important bridge between the materia medica and patients, right? So it's a link. This must, you should improve your practice or your confidence with the help of repertory. And today I'm going to share a few cases. So then you will realize that it is how much important. Can you see my presentation?
Yes, sir. Yes, Dr. Onaksha, it's very clear. Yeah. Yeah. Purpose of this module.
Okay, now purpose of this module. Very important. Why we have chosen this module? So many students who have passed out BHMS and even MD, I would say, they don't know how to use repertory. They are not practicing on the base of repertory or with the help of repertory. They purchase softwares, but they don't know how to use it. So many students, so many doctors are asking after purchasing the software, sir, we forgot the repertory subject because we are not connected with that. We used to practice only on the symptoms with materia medica. So purpose of this module, to improve our confidence to find the right remedy in the practice. This is the one of the course on the repertory and different method of prescribing. See, why this, we are not comparing with any science, but why if you go to the allopathic doctor and if for a malaria treatment, they give chloroquine and then doses and everything in detail, they write down on a prescription and they tell you will be all right within 3 or 4 days, right? They give the so much confidence in you and they are also confident in prescription. Why? Because they know the doses, they know the remedies and their pathogenesis, everything in detail. If you use a repertory and you have correctly repertorized, if you have a group of medicines, then even in a dry cough or even a cancer, your prescription is based on the genuine sources. In a repertory, Kent as well as synthesis repertory, the sources are also given. So you know that this is a Herring contribution, this is a Kent contribution, this is a other homeopath who has a practice only a particular disease condition has introduced the rubrics and the medicine. So the sources are very important, and on that you can be confident enough to tell your patient that you will be all right within 3 or 4 days. Patients always asking that, are you able to treat these conditions? Are you giving medicines which take how much time to relieve complaints? So this confidence only you will get when you, because you have a data, you have a authentic sources, and on that background, your prescription confidence will build double. Please take it from me, that definitely improve your confidence. Now in this course, outline of the course, those who have already passed long back 15 years before, 10 years before, they are not using repertory. So they have to refresh your knowledge. Basic thing. Start from basic thing. Dr. John has told me that so many homeopaths were asking, why don't you not treating BBCR or any other repertory, modern repertory. But Baba, aapko basic bhi sikhna hai, pehle basic learn karo, baad mein you can go advanced course. We will keep advanced course also, but first start with the Kent is a Bible or Kent is a Gita for us in a repertory. So definition of repertory, need of repertory, uses of repertory with the practical clinical cases, that is very important. That's not only just one line or two line, limitation also there, you know, everything has an advantage and disadvantage. Then various repertories. The first we will talk about the Kent as well as the synthesis repertory and the techniques of repertorization. As Dr. Kulkarni sir has told her, thanks to all software companies, every software has advantages. But you should know which way you have to be used. Techniques are very important. Sometimes you have to cross-reference, sometimes you have to combine the rubrics and then find out the remedy. Then there's definitely steps of repertorization. We take case. After taking case, you have to analyze. You have to evaluate the symptoms. All the symptomatology is not sufficient or not required for the repertorization. Repertorization, we believe in individualization. So you have to individualize your patients and then you have to analyze and evaluate symptoms. Selection of the remedy, then selection of the dose, repetitions, and management of cases. These all things we will include in this course. And I'm sure those who are not using repertory, those who are practicing only on Matria Medica, or those who want to refresh their knowledge, this course will be boon for them and your confidence will be double what you have now. So repertory is a very important tool which has to be used artistically, intelligent way, and that will reach to the success very much. Now, role of repertory is to bring about all the remedies for a particular symptom to our consideration. In the present day practice, we have to deal with a large number of cases having complex problems, right? And if you are more senior, you have a lot of cases. You have a lot of cases, so many cases, so many complications. It's very difficult to find out the similimum after listening history and with the knowledge of Matria Medica. If you're using the Matria Medica only, I'm not blaming those who are not using repertory, but I'm talking to improve ourselves, to upgrade our knowledge, to become more confident. Repertory is must. We are not like a Dubey sir. We are not like a Bholanath Chakravarti sir. Or we are not like a Nash that who have a Matria Medica tip of the tongue. Even Hahnemann as well as the Kent as well as all the stalwarts who had proven many medicines were using repertory whenever the case is required. So referring to even one or two main important symptoms gives us some remedies which can differentiate to arrive at the most similar. Kai log aise hai ki jo do ya teen symptoms pe practice karte hai, to unke liye bhi repertory important hai. Agar aapke paas 100 patients ki OPD hai, to aap every case ko repertorize nahi kar sakte. I can understand. We have an NGO, we cannot practice in each and every case in a repertorization. Today, one patient we had, the lady who has a diabetes, hypertension, and then she has a problem of the urination frequently. Now, urination frequently, and she has been to urologist, and urologist has suggested to sonography, and then sonography, there was a retention of the urine. And because of that, she used to get infection frequently. Now, she told me that my diabetes are well under control. It's a 6.5 HbA1c. I don't want to take allopathy medicines because last year I had taken antibiotics and again is a relapse. So please, doctor, sir, do a presence for my urination problem, frequent urination, retention of the urine and burning while urination, and then probably the diagnosis of the stricture of urethra. These are the four rubrics we have taken. And now you can you think about the medicines on this symptomatology? You can think about arsenic, you can think about cantharis, you can think about other remedy, common remedy. But when we repertorize, remedy came climatics. Now you know the rubric remedy climatics has an affinity on genitourinary, but the totality. Within just 1 minute, we came to know that the climatics cover all the symptoms. So every person's mind will not click climatics. You may, because you may have experience that of climatics, that's why. Otherwise, you will think about cantharis or common remedy. So climatics was given. So this way, it is very helpful. Now, another case I would like to. So today I'm just talking about the how much useful repertory with cases. I'm not going to speak for a 1 hour. It's a 30, 40 minutes is given by Dr. John to, because the, we have to show you how repertory can help. Now, another wonderful case. Listen properly. 62 years old lady, Sindhi lady, under my treatment of for osteoarthritis since 2000. And she's known to suffer from ischemic heart disease, diabetes, hypertension, and cirrhosis of liver. Now, this lady's daughter is homeopath, and she called me to visit in a hospital, one of the most reputed hospital of Baroda, on the 9th December 2000. Severe orthopnea, little exertions, unable to lie down even for a few minutes. Gasping for breath with a desire to take breath. She has to sit up to have a breath. More aggravation by lying down, talking, better by lying on the right side, better by sitting with the heel bent forward, and better by open air. Wants windows and doors open, kept open. She has a pain in the precordial region, which appear every 10 minutes. Heaviness in the chest, more while lying down, as if heavy load was placed. Aggravation from slightest exertion and better by irritation. Constant pain in the left shoulder, better by pressure, and sensation of numbness in the right leg. Thirst was normal, appetite quite diminished. On examination, pulse 70 per minute, blood pressure 138 by 92. Tongue was thin, white coated, pitting edema on both the legs and face redness. Now she was not able to lie down, so definitely the angio is not possible. So they were waiting. The patient should settle down and then they move for angiography. Investigation was done. X-ray, left ventricular hypertrophy, spine. Spondylitic changes, T wave inversion. Our Dr. John is very well with echo and cardiac because he has taken modules of ECG last month. So he's intensive, strongly intent, believe in all ECGs and advanced heart condition patients. So echo impaired diastolic dysfunction, left ventricular failure, and the blood report showing that WBC 9000, HbA1c 6.1, blood sugar was 310. All medications was going on in a hospital, but they wanted to go for an angio, but that is not possible because of orthopnea. Now the rubrics are taken. Respiration difficult while lying back. Difficult sitting bent, forward emulation. Extreme orthopnea, difficult exertion after sitting emulation, chest pain while lying, chest pain rotation emulation, chest pain exertion. And the last was the pitting edema and the face red. Now, after repertorization, the medicine was coming Kalika, 6:8. There was a typing mistake. Arsenic 5:12, Lyco 5:12, Convalaria 3:7, and Asafoetida 4:5. After the repertorization, definitely the group of medicine comes. That does not mean that whatever the medicine is coming first has to be prescribed. Some of the students and even the doctors are saying after spending a lot of money in a software and after working. Repertorizations done physically also, the remedies coming first is not helping to my patient. We always tell to our students that whatever the medicine coming in the first should not be prescribed to your patient. You have to go to the cross-examination with Materia Medica. Ultimately, you have to refer Materia Medica. This is the just the vehicle to reach our destination. To reach our destinations, easiest comfort way and in a time. That is the only use of repertory. It's a tool. Too much expectations from repertory and repertorization. That whatever you have done repertorization, now your work is over. The first remedy you should prescribe your patient is the wrong thing. You have to use your materia medica knowledge. You have to cross examination and then you have to prescribe. So here, I would just go into all medicines. And then after cross examination, here the extreme orthopnea caused by slightest exertion and the anasarca and the action of convallaria majoris. If you read in materia medica, increase the actions of the heart, energy of the heart actions, and its utility in angina pacis made me to think this remedy. Now just ask yourself, convallaria comes in your mind. If I have not repertorization, I am sure, I am very honest, I would have never used convallaria before 2000. I was not knowing about this remedy. But after repertorization, when he has just read materia medica, convallaria has a too much action on the heart. And then after Franz Vermeulen has a mention about this remedy, and that may confirm my prescription. You won't believe, giving every overleaf of the day, and the next day the patient was better and taken for angiography. So convallaria will never come in our mind. We will think about kalika, arsenic, or some all routine medicines. But when we require correct medicine in time, very important, in particular time is also important, then the patient will improve like it. Another case for repertorization. A case of my own assistant, doctor, she has started sudden twitching and jerking of the eyes while reading. She was sitting with me and suddenly started twitching of the eyes. When she looks at someone, there is a pendulum-like action of the eyes. But she could not fix her eyes. This stops only during sleep. All the motions subside during sleep. She told me this has happened many times. Now, what do you think about this medicine? In the only and very important symptom. If you see in the repertory rubric, eye movements, eyeball, like constant pendulum, agaricus is there. You know the agaricus is a good remedy because of your knowledge of materia medica. Many, many students have not learned agaricus materials. But when you repertize, the remedy comes in. Right. I request to participant. Mute. Thank you. So agaricus was given in the clinic time only.
Doctor, you unmute yourself. Dr. Ronak Shah, I muted everyone. Just unmute yourself. That's better.
Okay. So I given agaricus few doses to my assistant and then she recovered. So many times happen, you will have a very non-pathognomic symptoms and you are not able to recollect medicine. Then what you will do? You just take the symptoms, convert it to rubrics and just refer repertory. Immediately the remedies comes. And while looking to the one remedy, you are looking for other remedies also. So your knowledge will improve day by day. While in materia, you will not going to read every day drug. You ask yourself, are you giving a time for reading every day 3-4 hours or more than that? Because you are so busy in your routine work or you are in practice, you are not able to give that much time. Exceptional is a different thing, but I am talking about majority of. In my training time, I was told by my teacher, Dr. Farooq Master, from whom I have learned, in our DHMS course, there was no repertory subjects, SEPREC. I think Ajit Kulkarni sir also must be knowing that in those days, there was only one paper in a final DHMS, 50 marks organon and 50 marks repertory, and very few homeopaths were teaching repertory in a detail. My teacher was Dr. H.T. Madrasi sir, who used to teach Kent repertory philosophy, advantage, disadvantage, and construction, nothing more than that. Because he used to practice more on the mother teacher like Calcutta side. So we used to pass out with the help of organon and a few fixed questions about the Kent repertory, and then we complete our course. I was not practicing on repertorization when I have taken a training with my teacher in Bombay. Each and every case has to be repertorization. In those days, there was no software. So we were doing manually. It takes generally 2 to 3 hours. Every day we have to repertorize one case was given by him. And while doing repertorization, we have improved. Oh, anger remedies, restlessness remedy. You can tell now because you are daily acquainted with that particular rubric. Right? So, another case. Third case. A patient complained a lot of nasal discharge. Short case I have selected because it's a demo version. While eating. Now, anybody can tell me that nasal discharge while eating, which are the medicine? And are you able to recollect this medicine only in this important non-pathognomic symptom? It's a non-pathognomic symptom. You know the non-pathognomic symptoms are very important for practice in homeopathy to individual because it individualizes nasal discharge while eating. If you start from arsenic to zinc, you will not able to get the right remedy. Or you will never remember. This is a practical example I am sharing with you. Yeah, and this is very important. No need to go for a more detailed case taking, or even though you have a time, but you may not require at that time to prescribe because it's a very important symptom. He had to go to clear the nose several times during his meal. And that was very embarrassing. Now, peculiar symptoms, when look in the Murphy's repertory found under the rubric, there are many medicines. I think, can you hear, can you see all the medicines? Because I'm here, Dash.
You can see only the last.
Carbo animalis, clematis, naxomica, plumbum, senecula, sulfur, and trombidium, right? So trombidium was prominently mentioned along with other remedies. Now the patient had a pain in the lower abdomen, and you know the trombidium is one of the remedies for a dysentery. Beautifully worked. Bacillary dysentery, the trombidium is one of the remedy can give in acute cases. Immediately relief. Now, main dream mein bhi soch nahi sakta tha ki ye dawa mere dimag mein aayegi. Trombidium. If I have not seen the rubric. Frankly speaking, nasal discharge hai, toh humare dimag mein arsenic aayega, arsiod aayega, senecula, shilisha, everything will come. But specially,
kiti lag, atade kasa hai, cover kele kisa thoda sa garam lagta.
Participant kindly be muted when you enter. These are new participants who keep disturbing when they enter. Yes, sir. Sorry, you can unmute. These are the new participants.
So मेरे दिमाग में कभी भी ये ट्रॉम्बिडियम जैसी दवाई आएगी नहीं अगर ऐसा सिम्टम्स मिला तो. सो व्हाट आई मीन टू से ओवर हियर दैट वी आर नॉट दैट मच. वी ह्यूमन माइंड हैज लिमिटेशन ऑफ रिमेम्बरिंग द सिम्टम्स. Hanuman himself is not able to remember the 200 medicine with his. So. Hanuman himself was not able to remember 200 medicine which he has already proven. खुद ने प्रूव किया है वो दवाई के सिम्टम्स उन खुद को याद नहीं रहते थे. Himself was not able to remember. How can we remember 4,200 medicines with symptom A to Z? So those who are not using repertory, either they don't want to do or they don't want to upgrade or they're not able to do. That's why. That is the main reasons. Nobody wants to work hard in that direction, wants immediate result, smoothly, fast way. People have a tendency that, dawai de do, consultation le lo, or patient ko bhagao. No. You have to repertorize each and every case, even though you don't want to give medicine on the basis of repertorization. No problem. But you should do because it improves your knowledge. So this course is very important, and I'm sure those who are going to attend this course or enrolling the course, learning all the repertory with the practical utility. I'm not going to teach in a course of the chapter wise or theory point of view. Practical utility in your practice, and that will definitely improve your confidence, and your prescriptions will improve day by day. So this was a third case. Now another case, the last case was already 40 minutes ago. Our last case, young lady came to consult for genital warts. Now as soon as the warts comes, patient comes, thuja comes in your mind. Am I right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
With itching a lot, with occasionally burning. All investigation, including one for HIV, were negative. Now in synthesis repertory, under the chapter genital, the rubric, warts, itching and burning, sore, and the only one drug given is Sabina. So those who have a knowledge of Sabina, those who are using Sabina, they must have a Sabina in their mind. But newcomers, those who are not using much repertory as well as Sabina, may not thought about Sabina. You always think about Thuja first. What's that? Thuja de do bhai. Thuja se allopath doctor, dermatologist bhi Thuja dete, hume pehle Thuja hi dena chahiye. But here is a different thing. And that was a Sabina was given, and if you won't believe, in a 15 days the warts has disappeared, fallen. So here is my small presentation, the utility practice point of view, how it is useful, repertory and repertorization. There are many repertories. As we have seen in all about cases, we could not come to one remedy from our knowledge of Materia Medica. However, working out the cases with the repertory, we got the idea for the remedy which cured. Thus, repertory is an important tool in a modern day-to-day practice. Modern day mein repertory is must. Materia Medica to hai important, magar to reach the similimum, repertory helps. Please, beginners, those who are starting their practice, do not neglect this subject, because in a fourth year, the repertory subject is very small and they have given a 1.5 year. The students are neglecting this subject. Repertory mein kya padhna hai? Repertory practical subject hai. Usko jitna practice karoge, every day read one page. I heard that Dr. John has told me that Ajit Kulkarni sir has taken each rubric with the interpretation with the differentiation of medicine in last month. Psychology. Restlessness ki medicines, avarice ki medicines, differentiation, restlessness with the mental restless, physical restlessness, how arsenic rust oxide differentiate. So these are the very important which improve your materia medica. Now suppose the lycopodium I'm talking about. Now I have a lycopodium image in my mind that a dictatorial, egoistic, avarice, hot patient, desire sweet. Any drug you tell me, I can tell the core symptoms of each drug because of after using 30 years of practice, I have a understanding of the one drug with a particular essence. Then we will definitely go through the materia medica. Everyday practice. Practice makes men perfect like that way. Koi bhi subject ko practice karna jaruri hai. Koi bhi field mein practice karna jaruri hai. So here, this module is specially designed for UG, PG students who wanted to learn repertories and case taking and homeopathic practitioners, those who are not using repertory or wants to upgrading their knowledge in a practice, please join this module. Why important of this module? You can attend an entire course in the comfort of your home and clinic. This technology is superb technology. Corona ne itna sab sikha diya ki ye technology hum log abhi ghar baithe use karte hai aur isse hamara knowledge upgrade ho raha hai. 3-4 years before, the few homeopaths of Baroda who has passed out 15-20 years before, as I told you, there was no importance given to this subject. They told me, sir, can you take a refreshing course for a repertory? Because we have to refresh our knowledge and we have to upgrade. So this is the, again, I'm remembering those days and Dr. John has called me, hey, why don't you take the repertory course? And then this course will refresh our knowledge and we will be more updating. So in this course, bilateral participation of speaker and delegates. We will have a question answer also. So many difficulties. And I will also learn from many times from students. So many small rubric students teaches us. Sir, this is one of the beautiful rubric we got from this patient. And the deeper insight into each major repertory supported by clinical cases. That we are going to learn. Today also I have told a few cases. Practical approach which helps in future. Then most important, all participants will receive an e-certificate at the end of the course. So please enroll today because today is the last day. Tomorrow we are going to start. And there are so many participants are there. So once again, thank you very much for listening to me and giving an opportunity for a demo or lecture on the repertory subject. Once again, I'm thankful for Dr. John as well as respected Dr. Ajit Kulkarni, sir, for listening and for bearing. Any questions, you can ask directly or you can ask me in the chat box. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ronak Shah, for a beautiful, concise presentation. There are questions in the chat box. You want me to read the questions or you'll read it?
Yeah, please. That will be better. Okay.
So I will take, there are some questions about whether the lectures will be recorded. Yes, the answer is the lectures will be recorded, but there has to be a valid reason for you not. And it is always better to be personally present because it is an interactive session. You have every opportunity to ask Dr. Ronak Shah any doubts. But for whatever reason, if you are not able to meet the time of 3:30, 5:30 on a Monday, then definitely you have every right and we will record it and send it to you. But kindly advise you not to keep sharing the recording with any non-participants or non-registered participants. This is only between the participants or delegates and the speaker. And it is mainly meant for you so that we want you to be a better homeopath at an individual level. Okay. and which repertory do we need to refer during the course? A question to Dr. Ranakshi.
First of all, the Kant repertory as well as synthesis repertory. The Kant is a Bible for us. On the base of the Kant, other repertories publication is there. So Kant repertory is must. And second, who want to know more about the modern repertory, second is synthesis. These are the two repertories are very important because all the rubrics generally you will get in from these two repertories. And then advanced course, we will go for the other repertory like Murphy repertory, Fatak repertories, or BBCRR, whatever repertory, other in advanced modules. But this is in these four modules, we are going to learn these two repertories with the clinical cases.
Okay. Most of the questions are how do you register? To register, today is the last day. Tomorrow, we will be starting at 3:30. To register, kindly write down the Google Pay number. Its number is 9870. I will type it in the chat box also, but I'll repeat 9870797755. I'll repeat it. The number is 9870797757. On this number, you have to pay. The cost is registration fee is 1,000. For four sessions, it means approximately 250 for almost a two and a half hour session, which is definitely not even going to cover up the travel fees if you have to go and attend actual live seminar. So it is at a nominal cost, a very minimum cost in the comfort of your home or your comfort of your clinic. And we have kept a time which is quite, sort of easily, most of them practitioners either practice in the morning and evening. So it's a time which is available at hand. So we want you to utilize that time so that you can learn the repertory in that spare time between 3:30 to 5:30. Am I clear? The number is again, I'll repeat, Google Pay today at 9870797757. And the name will be registered in my wife's name. I'm Dr. John. My wife's name is Joyce Rodriguez. So that is what it is. And once you register, you send the confirmation on my number. My mobile number is 808-250-3370. Okay, that is as far as the registration is concerned. And the course is for 1 month. It is once a week on Monday for 4 Mondays. Every Monday beginning from tomorrow. So this module is in the month of August. So we have the dates August 9, August 16, August 23rd and August 30th. Am I right, Dr. Ranaksha?
Excuse me, sir. If someone wants to attend from out of India, how are they going to pay?
They will have to pay whatever is there. Who is this person calling?
Hello, sir. My name is Ankita and I'm calling from Australia. So if I'm a student of Dr. Ranaksha. And I want to attend this. So can I do the bank transfer? Is it okay?
I'll send the bank details to you personally. But your mobile number is not complete. You please send me your complete WhatsApp number.
And okay, sir.
I will give you the bank details. Is it fine?
Okay, great. And the fee is going to be the same 1,000 one or it's going to be the change? Because I can transfer from India. Is that okay, sir?
What does Dr. Ranaksha say? He's your teacher. Whatever he says, okay for.
sir, you, I can't hear you.
Only unmute.
Yes, Ankita. Yes, nice to hear you. You can transfer from India, no problem. So Indian fees, 1,000 rupees of 1 month. You can do whatever the way.
Thank you so much, sir. I'm feeling blessed right now that I can learn again from you, sir. Thank you so much.
You are connected with your student in Australia.
She is in Australia at present.
So he's very considerate and very generous. He doesn't mind you paying the same fee, whether you are in Australia or in America. No problem. Correct?
Yes, sir. Thank you so
she's
much,
my,
sir.
She told me she's my student, what I can say as a teacher.
Yes, sir, I'm from 2007 bench and I want to say one thing. I wanted to learn with you, But at that time, I didn't have that much money to pay you. Seriously, sir.
Okay.
I have the money, but we will not charge you.
No. At that time, in 2008, I didn't had, and right now I have the money, but I'm not there, you know.
Yeah. No problem. We can teach you from here, no problem. Whenever you want.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Dr. John has mediated to bring Zoom to Australia.
Yeah. Thank credit goes to Dr. John. Right.
Thank you so much for joining us. Okay, by Dr. Jagruti Rabuwala Singh, metamorphic aspect of rubric is difficult to understand. Can you put a light on this? What is metamorphic? Dr. Jagruti, can you personally ask this question?
What is meta?
Metaphoric, I think. Sorry. Yeah. It is metaphoric aspect. Maybe she needs to explain you this. Dr. Jagruti, are you there?
Is not there.
Sir, especially about the delusions and deliriums, no? Like how?
So, delusion and delirium.
Yeah, right. Like in Pathak repertories, if you see the delusions and deliriums are not given much. But if you see synthesis, there are so many delusions are given. So sometimes we use it as a metaphoric meaning, you know. So sometimes I find it difficult whether how much to go with the imaginations and use a conceptualization of the symptom. As in the Kent, we don't find so many delusions.
Yeah. I understand.
Because you're taking synthesis, that's why I just...
So for that is require a lot of time to understand each and every delusions and deliriums. Every time the different meaning according to the patient's situation and conditions. Right, like delusion legs cut off, the people will think that is an inferiority complex and that is why the people is walking on a knees. That is the inferiority complex of Barraita carbonicum that was understanding with many stalwarts. So every time the delusions, 4 second feeling is there. So delusions, that means the patient is himself is feeling is being very lonely. When they are, have a strong feeling, is the loneliness is there, that time we will take delusion 4 second ease. So such a delusions require the whole day to understand each and every the rubrics as well as the differentiation of the medicines in each rubric. So we will have a Dr. John the another session in the future for an advanced modules of repertory. We will keep the one lecture on delusion and deliriums.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Any more questions? Dr. Ajit Kulkarni, sir, are you there?
Yeah. I am here and I was listening very carefully. And it was a very instructive, and the way in which 3 cases are presented, very instructive. And because he practical session by Ronik, and I think this is exactly what the student needs. That it is not a platform for giving when the repertory was published during which. Period. And then there are a lot of questions to our students. So who wrote the repertory? Banugasan wrote at what time?
Wo sab the books mein hi hai. Sab exam oriented hai. Sab pass hone ke liye. Now these people have become a doctors. So we have to learn practical things.
Well, the 3 cases are very nice. The first case of convalidia. And his remarks that convalidia could not have, you see, touched the mind of a homeopath unless there was a repertorial probing.
Right.
So I think all the 3 cases are very fantastic, especially the case of agaricus, of the spasm of the muscles, for which agaricus is always indicated. But without repertory, it is difficult. And we have so many remedies against the spasm. So then the homeopath starts, today I will use MacFoss. Tomorrow not better, cipram metallicum. And even if not better, Ignatia.
Right, sir.
In a case, he's trying to understand and connect the symptoms which are related to the patient. So I think the patient and the repertory, patient and the rubric, and then patient and the materia medica. That connection, which is very important for a homeopath, has been given very well by Ronak Shah. So I thank him for a very instructive lecture And I must say that all these three cases have taught every one of us, including me, a lot of things to understand about our great science of homeopathy.
Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, sir.
Dr. Ajit Kulkarni, for a wonderful insight. Why this module? We don't want the newer homeopaths to waste 30 and 40 years. What earlier we didn't have, today you all are having. You are having wonderful teachers, experienced teachers, willing to share their knowledge. You have to learn from the best. Spare your 30 years. You started from tomorrow. Am I right, sir?
Yes.
In next 30 years, you'll be number one in the world. Don't worry. If you started today.
So you see, one who always thinks that he is a student will become a good teacher.
Yeah.
I always teaching the students only because I wanted to be a good student.
There are two questions. One from Dr. Archana Pai. Can you unmute yourself? Dr. Archana, are you there? Second one, Dr. Jagruti. If you are there, you can ask your question. Otherwise, we'll wind up the session. Wishing all of you here, Dr. Ronak and Dr. Ajit, today for 97. Okay.
Okay.
You are almost coming to a century. So this is
not first
97, not out. Okay. Still batting.
Still batting. Okay.
How it begins, and I want all the 97 to register. It is for your own. We are here to help you. And we can help you only if you help us being part of this wonderful module tomorrow by Dr. Ronak Shah. And later on, we can only reach our goal. I always put as a teamwork. Together, everyone achieves more. That is my basic funda in life. Together, everyone achieves much more. As individual, we may be celebrities. We don't want celebrity homeopaths. We want homeopathy to be there. I've been trying to tell Dr. Ajit Kulkarni all the time. We got homeopathy from Germany. Now we have to join hands together in India and take homeopathy back to Germany from India.
Like a marathon.
Yeah, like a marathon.
Thank you, sir.
And okay, bye.
You and participant, be safe. Dr. Ajit, sir, thank you for taking a precious time on a Sunday. I really appreciate it. And God bless you. And one more announcement. Next Sunday, that is actually starting on 14th August, because 15th August being Sunday, we are not able to start it. The cardiac module. I just finished rather three sessions on ECG, as Dr. Ronak Shah said. I being an intensivist thought that without reading an ECG, it would be very difficult to treat cardiology and homeopathic medication. So although we have done it, we'll be one step closer to understanding heart and cardiology. And it will be taken none other than Dr. Ajit Kulkarni, sir. Registration is on. The first session will be on Saturday because 15th August is Sunday. So 14th August, Saturday, the time is 3 to 5 p.m. And thereon, the following Sunday, it will be on the 22nd August, 29th August, and the 5th of September. That is all three Sundays. It will be between 3 o'clock and 5 o'clock. So registration is on. The number is same. You can Google Pay on 9870-797757. But just mention that cardiac module. So you can pay for a repertory module and a cardiac module. Because we promise we want you to be the best homeopath. And in what way? We have already done psychology, Dr. Ajit sir. We have done psychiatry. Now Dr. Ajit sir is taking the third module on heart. I have taken on ECG. We have Ronak Shah who will take repertory. And similarly, after this, the best module will come on body language, which is the biggest contribution of Dr. Ajit sir. Which will have two modules. That will be in the month of, I think, September and October. And I think it is a must. It is mandatory for every homeopath. I have read his book and it says that 65% of the history is the body language of the patient. They say there is no way a patient doesn't communicate. He and she always communicates through body language. Whatever history we take for 1 hour and 2 hour and 3 hour, it only gives maximum 35% of information. And that is the reason our prescription goes wrong. If the history is confirmed with the body language, I don't think so. We can go much wrong. Am I right, Dr. Ajit sir?
Yes.
I would expect each of you to please, at least the month of September and October, to be committed to learn. This is one thing which was never taught in any homeopathic medical college, the body language. And this is the latest contribution of Dr. Ajit sir. which I'm very thankful to him. And when I read the book, and I said, this is what I missed for the last 35 years. And I'm very happy today. The time the patient enters, the time the patient goes out, even without talking to the patient, a lot of confirmation of remedies happen. Because they say, words can lie, body cannot lie. I repeat, words can lie, body cannot lie. And the truth is always there. Yeah. That is why a child is the best body language, and we need to understand body language. So thank you so much. And I
thank you, sir.
Leave now. And you want to say thank something you. About body language, sir, Dr. Ajit? A small introduction for 2 minutes?
Yeah. You say that our body is an ambassador of ourself. Body language is the synthesis of the mind and body together. The system giving you the message, what I have to give to the outer world. So the inner world gives to the outer world something as a symbol, as a metaphor, as a sign, as a cue, as a body language signal. These signals comprise the characteristics as well as common, making a totality of them along with the verbal exchange. Make a very good totality, a redefined totality, to understand the depth of the human being and its counterpart in Mater America through the repertory. You know, all of our predecessors have worked very hard to give you innumerable body language gestures. Take for example, while the proving of stramonium was being conducted, there is a proving which has been confirmed. A stramonium patient talks more through the hand gestures than through the words. Very interesting, no?
Yeah.
This is written in the Encyclopedia of Mater America by T.F. Allen. So see the level of their observation as far as the proving data is concerned. So we have innumerable body language gestures in our repertoire. Let us take, for example, biting of the nail, which is an intra-psychic communication, described already. Putting the fingers in the mouth. Now, Freud came afterwards to give us the idea of oral phase. But the human experience, as suggested by Hahnemann, long back, 260 years back, give us what Freud is able to give today. See, homeopathy is always ahead. And to catch homeopathy is very difficult because we are backward. It is very difficult to be forwarding and to be parallel with the speed which homeopathy comprises, embraces the human species over the planet.
Yes, sir. There was only one question, whether these books on body language is available or not.
Body language book is unfortunately not available as a hard copy. But we are now giving the Xerox copy of this with the spiral binding. The binding has come out very nicely. So you will get the same feeling of the hard copy. It is available at the cost of rupees 800 plus the charges of the courier. So you write to me, you write to John or to my son, Dr. Nikhil, and we will send you the book. Yeah.
Any of the participants need can write to me on my WhatsApp. Yeah. I will forward that to Dr. Ajit sir or Dr. Nikhil, Dr. Ajit sir, and we will do the needful. Please kindly send your postal address so yeah. that we can courier it. So we are trying to reach to your home. Only you have to take efforts, your hard work.
And I think before we begin the session of the body language, if the people purchase this book and go through them, it will be a great asset for them to understand what exactly I want to contribute in terms of the body language.
From now on, they have a full 1 month with them. So maybe in the next 10 days, if they take the book, maybe they have a good 1 month to read it correct. Before we actually start.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. So we wind up now.
Yes, and thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Enjoyed it.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thanks.
A wonderful presentation, Dr. Ronak Shah.
Thank you.
We start with the opening batsman tomorrow, the first innings. All the best.
Thank you.
Your clock. for login, and we will start the session. All right.
Okay, bye. Bye bye. Thank you.